Life is a miracle. Love is a miracle. Let's live the miracle now. We are here because there is one word that is now operating on our behalf. And that word is justice.
Yes.
Justice.
Yes, we need justice.
Justice.
Yes.
Compassion and understanding only works when we have justice. A lot of our young people are angry.
Yes, we're angry.
We pray for an answer. We pray for the blessing. Pedimos las bendiciones para la familia Nieto. Pedimos por el alma de nuestro hermano Alejandro Nieto. Que su espíritu descanse. Pedimos justicia por la gente que cometió este crimen. No se olviden que son ellos los guardianes de la comunidad. Lo están abusando la autoridad. Está pasando aquí, está pasando en Ferguson, está pasando en todas partes. All over the United States, people are angry. They're protesting about the lack of transparency from the authorities, the call of silence. We want the people responsible to come through and to be responsible to justice by the people. We are the people. Somos la gente. Queremos justicia. Si no hay justicia, no hay paz. Without justice, we'll have no peace. The whole.
Brutality.
Life is a miracle. Love is a miracle. Let's live the miracle now. We are here because there is one word that is now operating on our behalf. And that word is justice.
Yes.
Justice.
Yes, we need justice.
Justice.
Yes.
Compassion and understanding only works when we have justice. A lot of our young people are angry.
Yes, we're angry.
We pray for an answer. We pray for the blessing. Pedimos las bendiciones para la familia Nieto. Pedimos por el alma de nuestro hermano Alejandro Nieto, que su espíritu descanse. Pedimos justicia por la gente que cometió este crimen. No se olviden que son ellos los guardianes de la comunidad. Lo están abusando la autoridad. Está pasando aquí, está pasando en Ferguson, está pasando en todas partes. All over the United States, people are angry. They're protesting by the lack of transparency from the authorities, the code of silence. We want the people responsible to come through and to be responsible to justice by the people. We are the people. Somos la gente. Queremos justicia. Si no hay justicia, no hay paz. Without justice, we'll have no peace. The whole.
A ball for Alex!
Yes!
people, youth in a broad manner, all you come up here.
Ben, Margarita, come go up
here.
There.
Where are the men?
Ben.
Where's Benji and Margarita? Pacheva? Come up here. I want to see you all here.
You Indian.
How's everybody doing?
Yeah.
Oh, come on now.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, I've seen so many beautiful black and brown faces in my life. Welcome. A couple of things. My name is AJ Napolis, and I'm with Coleman Advocates. We do a number of different things regarding transforming and making the juvenile justice system a better place for our people and also educational rights. What people may not know is that Alex worked with Coleman from 1999 to 2002. And Alex at that time did a number of different things for us. He was organizing for us. He was going to meetings as a young person. He was organizing other young people. He was going to a lot of meetings when we had to take our issues and our concerns to the politicos. And he was representing young people. That's what he was all about. Those of you who know him know this. He was always involved in a lot of different things to make this community a better place. I also want to say that to the parents who are here, that I'm so saddened by your loss. I'm a parent. I have four children. And I don't mind sharing this with people that if anything ever like this ever happened to any of my kids, I would be devastated. And I'm not even going to lie. I'd be angry and I'd be upset and I would want justice immediately. Do y'all hear me? I would want that justice immediately. That's how I feel. That's how I feel. And as you can tell by my voice, I'm angry. I'm angry because this has been going on too long. It happens all the time, every day, every way, everywhere. And you guys read the news. You guys see the news. It's not just happening here. And the thing that gets you more upset is the
state constitution and take San Francisco. We are human beings who do not deserve to be killed. All right. Check this out. Homeboys and homegirls, look. It's about what Alex and I believe as well. Something we haven't talked about, and that is this. Amor. All right? I'm going to say it. You repeat, please. Amor. 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 All right, check this out. When they boast to you of the trillions of dollars that they stole, or the way that they have sold out their ethics, you will be able to tell your children, I rose with Alex Nieto on August 22nd, 2014. He was a good man that did not deserve to be killed. You'll be able to look into your children's eyes and tell them, I marched for Alex Nieto because Alex Nieto would have marched for you without even knowing you. Hence then, I want you to remember this day, this beautiful day, for the rest of your lives. Si se puede! Let's go! Let's do this!
Thank you.
time, but we still have time. I think we have
time.
Let's send them to social work school.
where they can learn how to deal. If they cannot unarm an 18-year-old daughter of ours with schizophrenia, then they have no business being in the office of police officers. Listen to the children. Listen to your heart. Listen, oh my people. Listen deep inside. Sing it with me. Listen to the children. Listen to the children, to your heart. Listen to your heart. Can't hear you, come on. Listen, oh my people, listen. Get off. Thanks for breaking the fast with me. When they killed my cousin in Indio, California, they laughed at us. They laughed at us and they said, nothing's going to get done because it's a good old boy network. What we had to do is we went outside to the state and federal. That's the only reason we won. And that cop went to jail. Went to jail. Involuntary manslaughter. He shot him from 9 inches to his head. Executed my cousin. But because he used the gun, he went to 7 years. They tried to change it. We got to get it out of the local, and we got to pull it to the state and federal. Gracias. Thank you. Viva Alex Nieto.
Viva Alex Nieto. Viva Alex Nieto. Okay, we're going to have a couple of other community speakers, and then we are going to start the Justice y Amor for Alex Nieto committee speeches. Our beautiful Mission Mayor, Roberto Hernandez, will come up. Yeah, give it up for Roberto. All right? And then the Attorney of Record, one of the most famous and infamous and most powerful civil rights attorneys, our attorney John Burris and Adante Pointer, they will come up here and speak. But first we have a few words from this beautiful woman right here. Please give it up to her.
My name is Gloria Larriva. I live in a mission for 33 years. And it's our mission in our San Francisco. Very quickly, sisters and brothers, I know it's short time. I was in Ferguson this past weekend. I was there, and they're talking now about how calm things are, but they're only calm because of hundreds of police from city, county, state, federal, 50 FBI agents going door to door in the black community. They're not checking out what the cop did. And if you see today, CNN just released a video of the 23-year-old man who was shot to death in St. Louis. It's horrifying. It's what they did to Alex. And Francisco is right. It's not fear. It's utter racist disregard for the people. They hate the people. And we have to fight together. This is international. People are calling us from all over the world in solidarity with Ferguson, in solidarity with the people of the United States, black and brown, Asian, Native, white. And I want to say that I just got shot with a rubber bullet there, and they were just firing away hundreds of bullets on the people, mothers, children, babies in front. It was 3,000 people marching Sunday night, 3 hours before curfew, and they blocked us and started firing. It was horrifying. I have video. I got video of it. We're going to show it Tuesday night at the Answer Office. Thank you to all of you. Alex Nieto presente!
Alex Nieto presente! All right. We have one last speaker before we start the main card, Supervisor Michael Nolte. You're running for Supervisor. Come on, Michael Nolte. I know you've done great work. You've tried to do great work for the community. Let's hear what you have to say.
Sure. I just want to let you know that my grandfather was born in the Mission, and my family was here before when it was called Mexico, and so we know what it's like to keep the citizens of San Francisco safe, and we need to have it safe. And when things like this happen in our neighborhood, when people are brutally murdered for whatever reason, investigations need to happen. And anyway, I'm running for supervisor in District 6. I also have my twin brother. He's running for supervisor in District 8. And our platform is to try to keep the family values in San Francisco. We're having gentrification. If we can't live here, we can't afford to be here. So we, as San Franciscans, need to stay here. Thank you for your time.
Okay, thank you, Michael. And you know what? Let's get back to Amor for Alex Nieto. If you're on the sidelines, come on over here, because we're starting right now what we're starting something that has always been, and that is the spirit of Alejandro Nieto, my homeboy, okay? All right? And what we're going to do right now is I'm going to say a few words. Adriana Camarena, who's with the Justice
Department.
All right, Tito, where are you from?
La Misión.
You know what? My father was an organizer for the United Farm Workers, and I became an organizer for the farm workers when I was 12 years old. I'm passing on that tradition and raising my son at this age so that he becomes an organizer and we continue to keep our familia tradition. You know, I used to, because you can imagine that at a very young age, I used to be very inquisitive, and I used to tell that child, how are we going to beat these growers? You know, they're so powerful, they have so much money, and they control the Senate and the Assembly and the Congress. And Cesar Chavez one night told me, he goes, Roberto, we're going to be like a mosquito. He said, you ever be at night and you got in the darkness of the night, you ever hear that? And boom, it bites you, right? That mosquito. And then, yeah, you got one in your back. And you run, and all night long that mosquito, and you try to catch it, you turn on the light and you can't catch it, and it bothers you all night long. He said, so he said, that's what we're going to do as part of the movement. We're going to be never going to go. We're going to be the mosquitoes. In those growers, in those landowners, and we're not going to go away. There's so many of us. That's all they're going to hear is. And if it takes 24 hours, 48 hours, a week, a month, a year, a decade, we will. And that's how we came up with the Si Se Puede, because that's what it takes. I said it 5 months ago. We're in this for the long haul. It's going to be a battle. And we're going to lose sometimes. But at the end, we're going to win. Because the truth, you can't get away from the truth. The fact that somebody with high technology recorded... Pop, pop! Pop, 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 pop! That's a record. There's a witness. You can't deny that. And that's what's been happening from what I've seen for years and years, being a victim of police brutality, because I've been beaten by the police. I've been arrested by the police for some of our civil rights movements. And we have fought, and we have won. And we have fought, and we have won. And it's taken years and years. So... today, I ask you to help this movement. Not just today. Go home and talk to people. Talk to 10 people, each and every one of you. There's 100 of us. And if 100 of us talk to 10 people, people know about Alex, 1,000, and ask them.